I want to briefly explain why, in this matrix vector multiply example, it's not safe to make the innermost loop a par 4 loop. First, observe that all iterations j write to the same location, y sub I. This situation is called a data race. So more precisely, a data race is at least one read and at least one write that can happen at the same memory location at the same time. So let's take two iterations j just as an example. Let's assume that I is equal to 1, and let's look at j equals 5 and j equals 100. And furthermore, suppose that y sub 1 has the initial value of 0. Now suppose I start executing the two statements simultaneously. And let's say I evaluate this multiplication and this multiplication at the same time as well. And maybe hypothetically I get the values 72 and minus 100. Now suppose I simultaneously read y sub 1. Then both statements will get the value 0 when they read y sub 1. Now suppose that j equals 5 executes its write first. Then y sub 1 will get the value of 72. But in the meantime, the j equals 100 statement is operating with the stale value of y. So when we do this sum, we'll get minus 100, and when we do the write, we'll overwrite the value of 72 instead of accumulating it. This is clearly an error. Now, a data race that leads to an error is called a race condition. So when you're designing parallel algorithms, you need to be careful to avoid race conditions. As a heuristic, it's often helpful to avoid data races as well. But an important point is that a data race does not always lead to a race condition. You'll see some examples of that throughout the course.